Hi everybody and welcome to another awesome tutorial. My name is Dawn and I am the Charlie behind this supernatural team that is nerdygocreative.com. Nerdygocreative is a place where you can create, learn, and share graphic design ideas and projects as well as get awesome design assets and a lot of freebies. This week we're going to be working in Adobe Illustrator and I'm going to be showing you how to create this fun and funky kind of retro seamless pattern. And we're going to be using the pattern creation tool in Illustrator, which is really fun and easy to use. I really like this kind of a pattern. It kind of has like sort of like a throwback 70s kind of feel to it. And it kind of reminds me of something that you would see up on a motel room in Dean and Sam's Wacky Adventures in Supernatural. So I really, really enjoy this one. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, so we're going to come over into just a new document. Size doesn't really matter all too much. I created these tiny little kind of retro shapes just with basic, circles and line tool available to me. I use this lovely color palette up here, which I will leave in a link in the description below so you guys can get all the colors for this if you guys really like the palette. And we're going to go ahead and select all of our items here. I've gone ahead and I sort of grouped them in a small little shape that I kind of feel like would work for this pattern. It's really easy to repeat. I just use my align tools to move everything into, make sure everything's same height, same width, distance apart, everything like that. So they're already, you know, really nice and aligned. So we're going to come up here to Object. And we're going to come down to Pattern, and then we're going to come up to Make. And what's going to happen is you're going to get the nifty little pop-up box that you just click Don't Show Again. And it's going to show you exactly the repeating pattern is going to go ahead and start. So you get this new dialog box, which is the Pattern Options box. And it gives you a lot of different options in here. We're going to focus a little bit on the tile type here. We're going to look at the overlap, copies, and, you know, how to reshape and resize things to get things to fit the way we like it. So, as you can see right now, we're looking at grid, and it's 5x5. And as you can see, while it works really beautifully and it does make a repeatable pattern, you can see that there's some little funky issues here that, you know, things are a little bit too close together. I'd like them spaced out a little bit more. And I wouldn't like them kind of just straight sort of like this. Well, it's nice. It's not something aesthetically that I'm enjoying at the moment. So we can play around with these tools and see which ones that we like the best. All right, so I'm going to go to brick by row. And as you can see, it kind of shifted everything to the side. But as you can see, again, it kind of, you know, it still has this gap here that's too close. They're too touching. They're too friendly. Which is, you know, you can actually move things around. We're going to come up here to this pattern tile toolbox. And this is where the really fun bits of the pattern tool, the pattern making tool in Illustrator comes in. So you can click on this box and as you can see, it kind of creates a transform box. So now you can actually move these toggles around and you can make the distance what you would like it. So those two were touching too closely, so I'm going to kind of widen them out, and then it gives sort of a more wider space. But then as you can see, there's a space here that's not super attractive, but in some patterns you probably could get it to work and it look really nice. So I'm not going to stick with brick by row, so I'm going to kind of come here, brick by column. Now here we're talking. This one, actually, it repeats it very beautifully. Everything's pretty, you know, aligned and straight, and there's no sizing issues that I can see really at all. So you can still use these toggles if you feel like you want to change the spacing up, make it a little bit shorter. You can get everything kind of scrunched together, and also you can, you know, move these ones, the top and bottom ones, and these ones will, you know, move everything closer together as well. But we're going to go ahead and take a look at some of the other tools that we have. Let me widen this out just a little bit. All right, so brick by column is looking pretty good. It's probably the one I'm going to choose, but we'll go ahead and check out the rest of the tools. I might like something better. So hex by column, and as you can see, it creates this little hexagon. This one actually is really nice too. I like this. It's a very nice condensed kind of pattern. It's repeatable, and yet it's got kind of slight, you know, different variations. So it's a little bit funky, which I kind of like. And again, you can move these toggles, make it larger, space things out. This one's actually also a really good option. I really like this one as well. And next we're going to go hex by row. And then as you can see, it kind of gives you a different kind of hexagon and it goes differently. So this one has a little bit of overlap issues, which if you had overlapping elements works really well. And this is where you would get into the overlap section over here down where these little buttons are. So this will like toggle basically what's going to be on top and on bottom, so that if you have something you want to hide or you want something on the top, this is how you would toggle it. So you can click right on front and this will, you know, change some things if they were overlapping to the sides, and then also the top and the bottom. So as you can see, these pink ones and these green ones sort of shifted space as to who was on top and who was on bottom. All right. And then as this pretty much just does exactly what you think it would be. It just sort of ups or downs the copies that are made. So you can kind of, you'll get more copies on the page. You can have one of three of one, and it'll kind of show you, you know, smaller sections as to how things will repeat. And sort of kind of like these ones where it's like smaller numbers is not as much, I don't think you can get an overall aesthetic as to like how your pattern is going to turn out as well as when you have something even more along the lines of this, like 3x5 is fine. Usually I like the 5x5, 7x7, then you can really kind of see larger, you know, swatches of the pattern. But I'm going to go ahead and go back to brick by column because that's the one I like the best. I'm going to go ahead and shift these back in so that they're closer together. I'm going to tighten the pattern up just a bit. And that's about good. All right. So what you can do up here is you can go ahead and name your new pattern, which I'm going to name it Leafy '70s Wallpaper. All you have to do is hit done. And it has already put it over here in my swatches panel right here, which is awesome. So first thing you want to do is kind of test it out. I want to see what it looks like. So I'm going to pull out my rectangle tool. I'm going to throw up a rectangle, which now is pink. And then I'm going to throw my pattern in. All right. And as you can see, yay, we have a repeating pattern of our nice little wallpaper. Okay, so let's say that you like this pattern, but you want to see more of it. You want it to be more condensed. The best way to do this is to go ahead and right click, hit transform. You're going to go to scale, and then we're going to come up here and I'm going to go to 70%. You want to uncheck your transform objects box, and then you can go ahead and hit okay. And so there you have a nice, more condensed, and you can go up or down either way, and your pattern's going to look pretty and beautiful the whole way. All right. So now you want to know how do I save it so that I can use it in another document? Well, so as you can see, I don't have the pattern saved over here. So what you want to do is you're going to make sure you have your pattern clicked, and then you're going to go ahead and hit save swatches. And then your swatches panel will pop up, and then you can name it Leafy 70s Wallpaper. And now when you come over into your new document, you can go ahead and load it by coming down here to the user defined patterns, find your pattern Leafy 70s, and it'll pop up for you in a new box. And there's your new pattern. All right, so as you can see, well, we made the pattern that's basically on the top hip here where it has no colored background. Well, how do I get the color background so I can, you know, switch it up and make it look a little bit more wallpapery? I will show you, my friends. So I'm gonna go ahead and just delete these. I'm gonna grab my rectangle tool, pull out my rectangle with my pattern selected. All right, and then I'm going to come over here to my appearance panel. If you don't see your appearance panel, you can just find it up here in Window and then go to Appearance. All right, so what you're going to come over here is I'm going to go ahead and add, I'm going to go ahead and add new fill right here. And I want to be the one on the bottom, so I can go ahead and have this one clicked. I can double click on this color. I can come over here. And I can go ahead and choose the lovely color that I want. And then there you have it. Boom. Very pretty. And you can come over here and test out all different kinds of colors. See what you like works best. I actually really do like this dark blue one. I think it kind of makes the pinks pop a little bit in this nice little golden orange color. But you can go ahead and play around with it, see what works for you, what you think is cute, pretty, and you can, it's endless possibilities. All right, everybody, there we have it. I hope everybody really liked this tutorial. We learned how to create a seamless pattern in Adobe Illustrator using the pattern tool. It was quick and easy and a lot of fun to create. You can do so many different things, so many different variations. You can play around with opacities and, you know, you can go kind of crazy with this tool. It's really, really fun and it's really great for a lot of projects. So, all right, I hope everybody likes, subscribes, and shares these videos. I create a new freebie or tutorial every week. And if you have any suggestions as to what you would like to see next, don't forget to leave me a comment below or go to nerdygirlcreative.com and send me an email. All right, create something amazing.